Hi everybody, I'm Corinne Blackstone and welcome to my computer. In today's tutorial, we're going to show you how easy it is to clear the cache on your Cricut design space. Now you may be wondering, what is a cache? Before we get into that, be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the crafty content I have coming. So think of a cache like a backpack. So the way I like to describe it is picture the Cricut cutie with a little backpack. And every time you make a design or use a font, some of that information from your design goes into that Cricut cutie's backpack. Eventually, that backpack gets really full and it makes it harder and harder for the Cricut cutie to move around and walk around. So you need to empty that backpack from time to time to make it easier for him to move. So it's that same kind of concept with Cricut Design Space. Having that cache be full can really bog down Cricut Design Space and make it run really slow and sometimes really super laggy. So I'm going to show you how to correct that. Let's go ahead and get started. Clearing the cache on your Cricut is so much easier than you think it's going to be. So I'm going to show you step by step. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do is open your folder viewer, which you can open really any folder. But what you're going to focus on is this panel on the side. You're going to scooch down until you find where it says this PC. When you click on that, you're going to see that you have some options. You may only have one. Now, I have multiple options because I do have an SD card plugged in. I have an external hard drive plugged in, and I also have my regular computer. So you're going to be focusing on your Windows C. That is your physical computer, whether you have a laptop, a desktop, whatever it may be. You want to open this computer item here. And you're going to see quite a few different files. Now, you may have some different folders than I do, but the one we want is the users folder, and you should all have this. Click on that one. You're going to go to the user that you're using. So whatever your name may be, maybe it's mom, maybe it's dad, I don't know, but whatever your username is. Now, I'm the only one who uses my computer, so I only have one username, but you'll find the one that you have your Cricut design space under if you have multiple users on your computer. You're going to open that user folder and you'll see you again have some different folders. You may have different ones than I do, but the one we want to focus on again is going to be this one right here, the .cricut-design-space. I'm going to open that folder. Now you're going to see a couple of different folders within this folder: events, local data, logs, native, update, and user data. I want you to go into your local data folder. Now, what you're going to see here is you're going to have this really nothingness, right? But I want you to click on this that has this like numbers on it, and you're going to see that you have a bunch of folders in here. So this is where we're going to clear out all of that gunk from this folder right here. Now you can go back and just clear out this number folder. You can also just physically clear out your local data folder. Either one of those will work, but you can go from here and do it, or you can do it from here. You can right click on this and you can go here to delete, or you can open this and you can just delete whatever this folder is. So it's going to be the folder that has all the numbers. You can right click on this and simply click delete. Now it's going to probably take a hot minute depending on the last time you did it. Now I did mine fairly recently, so it doesn't really take that long. Then I want you to go and make sure you go to your recycle bin, right click on it, and you're going to go ahead and just empty that recycle bin. And what that does is it just keeps your folder clean, your computer clean, all that stuff. Now I probably have stuff in there, so it's going to ask me like, do I want to make sure I want to delete these? Because some of the files I did delete earlier were pretty big. So if it asks you, you can just tell it yes. And it's going to clear out all of that information for you. Now, this should help your Cricut Design Space run so much smoother. So let me go ahead and open Cricut Design Space because I do want to show you that when you do this, it's not going to clear out like your projects or anything like that. It's just clearing out some stuff that it doesn't really need to keep in its brain, so to speak. So if I look here, you can see obviously everything looks the same. But if I go into like my stuff, I can look at my projects. Those are all there. If I want to make a new project and I want to use one of my old uploads, you'll see that those are all still there. So it doesn't mess with anything within your design space. It just helps clean up your computer. Now, if you have any questions about this or anything else that I do here on the channel, or maybe there's something that you want to know a little bit more about, or you're having some troubleshooting issues, please let me know. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content we have coming. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting!